Good morning and a warm welcome from Ice Sheffield then, as we have the first of four finals for you today. This is the under-16s game between the London Capitals, who actually finished second in the South and beat the Whitley Bay Beacons in the opening game on Friday afternoon, against the Chelmsford Rattlesnakes, who won the Division 1 South and beat Sheffield on the way in. So just looking at the London Capitals, Sophia Kouzaris is the goalie, played well in that first game against the Beacons. Number 5, Aurora Dobbs, was player of the game in that one. 11, Rebecca Voslinski, Canadian-born player, fantastic to watch. She'll be certainly one to as a threat for the Rattlesnakes. And number 13, Niamh Walsh, and 25, Tegan Walsh. They both looked good in that game. Captain, 34, Kiva Parsons, has experience in the Elite League with Guildford. So those are the main players to look out for on the Capitals team. And on the Chelmsford Rattlesnakes end, goalie number 73, Kira Waddington, is the backup to Marley Easton with Guildford. Number 8, Christina Powell, defender. She was fantastic in their semi-final win over Sheffield. 13, Matilda Howe. 18, Macy Allen. 27, and captain Cara Jones. 32, Isabella Jasinska. Number 40, Connie Fiedler, all with experience of playing either with Guildford or with Chelmsford. 71, Ava Adamson, an uncompromising defender. She's certainly one to watch in the future. 76, Freya Clark, and also Freya Price, as we are ready for the puck drop then. And we are underway. And it's the Capitals who come out with it. Sorry, Rattlesnakes even, who come out with it. And Christina Powell. Both sides in different jerseys to ones they were wearing on Friday. But lineups looking the same as what they were the other day. Christina Powell sending it forward. Rattlesnakes controlling, trying to find Aurora Dobbs, I think it was, who was in that low slot position. As the Capitals looking to play out, McMahon gets a touch on it. Christina Powell will control on the centre red line, sends it across to her defensive partner on the far side. Into the corner, comes back off the boards. Capitals looking to try and get out the zone, and they will do so now. Setting up in the offensive zone, nice hands there with shot coming in. And it was Rebecca Voslinski with that effort. Aurora Dobbs from the point forces Kira Waddington into the save. She'll hold on. And the Capitals will get their first offensive zone face-off then of the game. A minute 17 into the game. 15-minute periods, these of course, in the 16s. With the draw. Move on that far side. Chelmsford looking to carry out then. Just out of the reach of the Walsh there for the Capitals. I should say there is two. Was Niamh Walsh, number 13, is Aurora Dobbs again. Comfortable on the puck. She cycles back round. Still with Dobbs. Rattlesnakes being pushed back here. It's good early pressure from the Capitals. It looks like Aurora Dobbs is going to be spending a lot of time on the ice. So we're changing their D partner, but she's spent a lot of time out there. You do see that in the 16s. Certain players will post a lot of the minutes, as Izzy Jasinska will carry in. Coming off the foot there of Aurora. Worked back door, just couldn't be kept in by Smith, and Jasinska's going to drop back as Capitals looking to try and capitalise on it, if you excuse the pun. But the fast skating play on the far side, almost capitalising there. Shot comes in from Zizinska, it's blocked, comes back out, good save there. Look back to the crease, and Capitals just about scrambling it away here. I'm going to carry out now. Southwood, who was lively in that first semi-final against the Beacons, forces Kira Waddington into a save as she sweeps the puck into a corner. Kiva Parsons unable to keep it inside. And that will go for icing then on the Rattlesnake. So that will bring the play back down into their end of the ice. So 3:35 played then. Still goalless here, but these two sides having met four times in the regular season. The Rattlesnakes winning the first three, but a 3-1 win to the Capitals in the most recent game, which was at Ali Pali. So interesting to see how this one will play out. Control beyond the back of the net. Veselinski is making herself open there, working some space. Kiva Parsons on the near side of the boards is open on the point as well. The Rattlesnakes looking to break out here. Izzy Zizinska, who is so good at breaking out like that. She's taking on four players there and so strong on the puck. Rebecca Roslinski, though, collects a loose puck. She controls and finds McMahon on this near side. That's hands from her as she advances up the left wing side, cuts in towards the middle of the ice. And on that far side. And still with the Rattlesnakes, but just as I say that, Veselinski steals it back and looks to re-enter his zone, which will do. Four Chelmsford players around the row. Good hands from her. She tries to hold on, but it allows her teammates to make the line change. And importantly so, Aurora Dobbs back in possession then. Dobbs going up along the right wing board, squeezing between the player and the boards, in fact, and getting the puck into the offensive zone, and she'll have to drop back here, but holds on. Finds her defensive partner. Fiedler on this near side. Walsh chips it in, but then he'll have to drop back. It's Tegan Walsh, the number 25. Control by Tegan once again. And we're getting a whistle on the play for offside then, with 5:41 played at the start of the game. That will be a icing call on the Capitals. That brings the play back down to their end of the ice. Rattlesnake saying they want it on this right-hand side. Rattlesnake's win the draw then, keep it inside the zone. End-to-end, both sides having their chances inside the opponent's zone and creating some opportunities, but probably would say that Kira has been the busier of the two, slightly. Controlled over on that far side, picked off though by the Capitals. Niamh Walsh is open, she'll collect the puck here. Looks it back to Tegan. And then Capitals looking to break it out there, but didn't quite happen for them. Drop back, Chelmsford will get there, but it, well, in fact they won't. It'll be called for icing with 6:50 then played here. A lot on the line for this one. Winners of this game will be crowned under 16 champions, Chelmsford having lost out at the semi-final stage last year when they were beaten in an entertaining game with the eventual winner to Kingston Diamonds, whereas the London Capitals were winners 2 years ago in Widnes. So a lot of happy memories there for the Haringey Club. Sophie Games, who's with the Queen Bees and the Fire Bees, scoring the winner with about 7 seconds to go in that one against Kingston. It was a dramatic final. Arguably the best game of that finals weekend, in fact. It's controlled around the net by Izzy Zizinska. Save then. Coming in. Sophia Kouzaris. So we'll go again in the offensive zone then. Zizinska will take the draw. Oh, bummed effort there. As you have just seen the replay there, as we're back underway. And Kiva Parsons looking to carry up. Chelmsford look to build again with Zizinska, who's so good at carrying the puck forward. Gets a shot on net, but deflected away. Still with the Rattlesnakes as they control in the zone. Towards the high slot. Work back to Christina Powell. To the corner for Jones. Christina Powell going back to the bench, using the opportunity to make the change while her teammates are in the offensive zone there, and the shot coming in, but wide of the goal. Sent towards net. There's a stab at goal, but didn't really trouble Kouzaris. Capitals with that advance up the ice, that has to drop back, but now we'll go again with Jones. Forces Kira into another save then, and they'll get the offensive zone face off. It's been the last couple of minutes has been all Rattlesnakes, so Capitals will be happy to get out the zone. 9-11 played. Side by Tegan Walsh, banked it off the boards, but Chelmsford have players back. Nice layoff as Chelmsford look to advance up the ice. Fiedler and Dobbs then will dig it out the corner. Oh, he's all alone in the low slot there. I left it unmarked, but Kouzaris coming up with a big save. Probably the best opportunity of the game so far, and as we see the replay, Chelmsford just forcing the turnover in the corner there. Nice pass, but defensively left. Oops, the shooter unmarked there, and all open in the low slot, and the Rattlesnakes getting their shot on net, but they'll have to settle for the offensive zone face-off here. Looking to break out there, Zizinska gets it back, gets the drag back, but couldn't get it around Wharf, the defender. Zizinska on that far side, turning one way and the next, but in the end just getting outnumbered over there. But she steals it back before the Capitals could get out the zone. So the attack is still on right now. She goes short side and then into the pads. Cazares will just sit the pads on top. 10-25 played. I'll allow both sides to make the line change then. Over on that far side, kept in by the Rattlesnakes. There's Rebecca Voswinski, looks to carry forward. Going to split the D. Kiefer Parsons definitely trying to keep it in, which he did. Freeland looking to carry in, gets a piece of it, but Capitals have the numbers back there, and they'll look to carry again with Voslinski. Puck getting away from her. Didn't get it under control, and back come the Rattlesnakes then. Puck coming free over on this near side. Collected by Voslinski, who evades the first challenge, holds on to possession, needs to hang, just hold back because there was a Capitals player in an offside position, so she keeps a hold of the possession here. Fiedler on this near side. Voslinski forward. Gets a shot off, but she was almost behind the net before she could release the puck, so couldn't get in on target, but trying to spark her offence to some of the reach of Aurora Dobbs. Cazares, who just tips it on, helps it out for a teammate off the boards, but falling for a chance for player, and it's Zhizhenska, cuts back inside, went block aside there. And Cazares not happy for the little tap afterwards. The referee just going to have a word with her here, just saying to calm it down. I think Izzy's just a little bit enthusiastic there, but senior referees over got Lebet just having a word with her. And Cazares did give her a sort of a glance over there. I don't think she was too happy with it, but anyway, back underway. Going to get a whistle on the play now. It will be a penalty. And it's going to be on Aurora Dobbs, so she'll be a big player to lose for the next couple of minutes. But 12:39 then. That will take us almost up to the end of the period. This is the replay here. Yeah, she does bring her down. So I imagine that's a tripping call. So a first power play opportunity for either side. It's going to go away of the Rattlesnakes. Southwood controls in the corner, backs it off the boards. Christina Powell keeps it inside. Puck comes out the zone, and it is tripping, is the confirmation on the call. 2 minutes. Control beyond the back of the net. Nicely taken into the zone by Zhizhenska, and then the shot coming in, and they've scored! And the Rattlesnakes convert then. All they needed was 29 seconds to convert, and we'll see the replay in a second, but it was their first real entry into the offensive zone after the Capitals had cleared. And you can hear the noise in here. Still had a lot of work to do in this situation here. It was three Capitals players, but it was a reverse pass which set her up between the hash marks, and that was put home. And it's the Rattlesnakes with the lead. You can see the fans there, they're enjoying it. Fanatical travelling army from Essex. But a great goal to open final Sunday then. Of the goal now. over on that far side. Dzyzinska. Isabella Dzyzinska with the assist, the primary assist, as Niamh Walsh will control. She's been announced as Connie Fiedler, which is what I thought it was, but having spoke to one of their coaches last night, I believe it is pronounced Fiedler. Or was it Fiedler? I can't actually remember now, but I know it isn't actually Fiedler. So apologies for that, as that's going to be a tripping call. It's going to be Ava Adamson to be called for that. That means the Capitals are now going to have a chance to respond, as they have the power play now. 13:59 played then, so they'll get a minute and 1 second before the end of the period to work with, and then if they don't convert, obviously have the start of the second period. And it looks like Tegan Walsh is going to take the draw initially.
1 minute remaining in the first period. 1 minute remaining in the first period.
Over onto the far side.
Number 77.
You've seen the foul, banks it off the boards.
2 minutes for tripping. 13
minutes. And again, collected behind the net once again.
We'll change it on the clock.
Aurora Dobbs cuts back inside, gets some space for herself. And draw a nice drop pass to Vasilinski, who wraps a stick around that. Kira just using the edge of a blocker to help it on its way. Kept inside by Tegan Walsh on the far side. Banks off the boards, but not out. And I think it was just about on the blue paint, but it doesn't matter now as the Rattlesnakes push out. And Tegan Walsh does get regained possession, but the Capitals have to come out the zone. Vasilinski, nice couple of drag backs there, but couldn't get the finish as the Rattlesnakes will defend well, get it away. That will do it then for the first period, and there'll be 59 seconds left on that power play. We're going to take a short break. We'll be back with you in around about 5 minutes' time, so please don't go anywhere. Welcome back to I Sheffield then, as we are getting ready for the start of the second period of this under-16s final between the Chelmsford Rattlesnakes and the London Capitals. The Rattlesnakes currently with a 1-0 lead, having just recently converted on the power play, but Capitals still have about 59 seconds of their own to work with here. So we shall see how this one pans out then, as Ava Adamson has to serve the rest of her penalty for Chelmsford. Vasilinski with the draw, she wins it, and it gets back to Aurora Dobbs. Now Kiva Parsons. Going to be called for offside early on then. All of 10 seconds played at the start of the period, and we'll get the face-off just outside the Rattlesnakes' blue line. Well, the voice is a little bit croakier today. For this and three more games to go. Hopefully it will hold out, otherwise I'm going to sound a little bit like Sean Dyche by the end of the day, as Jones sends it across. For Kiva Parsons. Into a corner, as Dzyzinska will hold on. Doing a good job here, actually, on the penalty kill. Holding possession in a deep position, but Vasilinski's forced a turnover, couldn't quite enter the zone. It's a good poke check by Christina Powell, who's had a really strong tournament here. She is a player to watch in the coming years, as is Dzyzinska. Nice drag back, but couldn't get it around Kiva Parsons. Christina Powell, though, very much part of the England age groups, the 13s and 15s, I believe. It's doing great. So Chelmsford able to kill off that penalty then. Just over a minute into the second period. Work back for boards from Chandler, I think it was. Yeah, indeed it was. Izzy Dzyzinska, but Chandler again doing a good job here, just trying to keep the puck in the offensive zone, but Dzyzinska looking to get free, banks it off Vasilinski, but Pomeranz will regain possession. work back. Boslinski over on that far side. Looking to go again. Drop of a shoulder. She's getting up to full speed here. Being forced out wide by Adamson. That's good defending, although she has still got inside and fires. But big save from Kira Waddington. She'll hold on. And we're going to face off inside the Rattlesnakes zone. 2:01 gone in this second period. Rattlesnakes come out with it, but couldn't quite clear the zone. And Kira with the save once again. 2:09 played. And we'll get a line change here for Chelmsford. Good thinking, just in case they can't clear the puck out the zone, and it's like an icing. So an opportunity to get some fresh legs out there. Tara Jones carries it forward. Comes down this left wing side. Kiva Parsons forcing it out wide though. Kiva, who was part of the successful Capital side, were champions 2 years ago. So she'll have many happy memories of that. I think she's the only remaining player from that team. Could be wrong. But that team, a lot of those players aged out over that summer, which was why they had to rebuild, essentially missed out on a playoff spot last year. But back for this season. As Jones dumps in. Capitals looking to get forward with Aurora Dobbs. Pomeranz firing in, but wide of the goal. That'll be a save from Kira Waddington. That'll allow the line change then, but we'll see the replay here. Capitals entering the zone with speed. And a good effort. Back live now. 3:28 played here then at the start of the second period. And the Rattlesnakes looking to carry out. Puck just sticking on Freya Clark there. Christina Powell digging the puck free. Oh, it's nice hands there from Chandler. It's a bit of a whack in the face on the way through, but you go into the low slot, you're going to get your nose bloodied at times, and she wasn't afraid to get stuck in, try and get force that equalising goal. Still with the Capitals, nice pull back there, but strong defending around the net, and the Rattlesnakes are going to carry away. Can't quite clear the zone, now they will, via the skate of a Capitals player. And over on this near side, Christina Powell defending so strongly over here. McMahon upended. She's waiting on this near side for the breakout. Oh, continuing over on that far side then, and they've got a two-on-one rush here. McMahon's open, but it's going to get to Kira Waddington first. 4:51 played, and we'll get a face-off in the Rattlesnake zone. Off on the far side, Voslinski with a draw. Chancellor looking to get the break on the far side with Voslinski, with Zizinska, sorry. Chance of just trying to dig the puck out along the boards. Just behind the player, comes back to a high slot. Shot through traffic, charged down. Matilda Howe trying to make her way towards goal. Right on that far side, it's sent around and collected by Voslinski. She carries forward with 5:40 gone in this second period. She's going to be brought down. That's going to be a penalty. Yeah, it's almost like a rugby tackle as she was brought down there. Arms around the waist. That will do it. And Capitals going back on the power play, but we'll see a replay of it here. Nice work down that left wing side from the Caps. There's a advance, but yeah, balls down and no arguments, I'm sure, on that one. Tegan Walsh is going to take the draw against Izzy Zizinska then. It's Izzy who wins it for the Rattlesnakes. They can't clear, it's open to Miles who shoots. That's a routine save for Kira Waddington then, but it was worth having a pop from there for Miles. Hooking was the actual call as we're back underway. Almost 6 minutes played here then. Kiva Parsons fires from the point. There was traffic in front of the net, but I think, I don't know if Christina Powell got a piece of that and just helped redirect it away from goal, but either way, Rattlesnakes are working it away up the ice thanks to Cara Jones. Kiva Parsons will control. On that far side. Nice work from Veselinski. Gets it around the second player, but ease into the corner. Christina Powell not letting go of it. Close marking. Oh, but it's a nice setup from Gretzky's office. Almost playing in Tegan Walsh. It comes back to Kiva Parsons, who banks it off the boards. Carla Jones will pick that one off in the corner. 6:45 play. That's a nice releasing pass to Zizinska, but Parsons comes across. Those two teammates at the Guildford Lightning, of course. As Kiva Parsons continues to advance over onto a far side, just out of her reach there of Veselinski. She tried to control it with her foot, but it was a pass at pace. And she scored, though. Tegan Walsh was open as a passing option. She didn't need her. She's rifled it into the top corner, and no goalie in the world could have stopped that one. No, you couldn't blame Kira at all for that. She literally picked out the top shelf and ran it under the roof of a net and the crossbar. We'll see it here. Voslinski just too strong, ushering the chance of player off the puck, and she reacted quickest. She advanced and picked her spot and went top shelf where Mama keeps the best cookies, and that goes into the top corner on the glove side, and it's a 1-1 game. 7:07 played at the start of the second period. Bit of a delay before we're ready to go again. We'll get confirmation of that goal then. Rebecca Roslinski, we knew, was the scorer, but it wasn't assisted yet, of course, because of the turnover. But both goals coming on the power play then. We got a whistle on the play there with 7:38 gone. Just past the midpoint of the game then. Classic song from Utah Saints. What price for a name change in the NHL for the old Arizona Coyotes who are relocating there to be your Utah Saints? It has a good ring to it, doesn't it? Certainly. As the Capitals back underway. Their jersey is very much inspired by the Washington Capitals as that shot comes off the top of the stick of Kira Waddington and away, but the Capitals in the ascendancy here. Nice hands by Rattlesnakes as they advance. We wind up shots blocked. That one coming from Freya Price, I believe, who scored two of the goals on Friday afternoon or early evening against Sheffield. Had a great game in that one. It's Tegan Walsh looking to get inside on the far side, but trying to pick out a player coming through the slot, but could well defended by Chelmsford. Tegan Walsh controls. Puck up along the near boards. Farmer Jones works it back to Christina Powell. Move on to that far side. Jumped into a corner. Almost 9 minutes played here. Rattlesnakes retrieve the puck in the corner. Comes through for Tegan Walsh. Christina Powell will go into the corner to retrieve. Into a corner, there's two players from each side of the net. So Capital player who comes out with it, and Neve Walsh. Centering pass, but it's cleared. On the play. There's a bit of confusion there. I think Kira felt she was ready to play it. It did seem a quick whistle, to be fair, but both sides quite happy to go straight off to a bench to make the change. But Kira looking a little bit frustrated because she was ready to play it, and it means that the Rattlesnakes now have to defend a face-off in their zone. 9:40 played. By the Capitals as the Rattlesnakes are going to push out, but ever since the Rattlesnakes have taken the lead, it's all been Capitals. They got their goal back, and still a lot of momentum going their way. Action over onto the far side, collected by Chandler for the Capitals. Freya Clark comes in, nice poke check to break the play up, but Chandler will get the puck back in advance. Picked off though nicely on this near side by Zinnia Quilter. Honey Fiedler on that far side. Back come the Caps, but it's again Quilter who reads the play and controls. Freya Clark can't quite get the puck in the zone. Chandler over to alignment. In fact, Chandler will collect the loose puck on that far side now. She's going to squeeze herself between player and boards and came off worse as Chelmsford battle hard along that side. Comes back out to Quilter, who will control the puck behind the back of the net. 10:58 played. This game is as close as we were expecting, really. Bounced it off the boards. Over to Freya Clark, who will collect. Forward to Neve Walsh, and then collected by the Rattlesnakes. Jujinska, nice drag back, but an equally nice poke check coming in from the Caps as Kiva Parsons will advance. Marginal, well, it looked offside to me, but either way, the officials will let it go. Puck coming back in, then collected by the Rattlesnakes. 11:46 to go. Played here as Roslinski banking it off the boards to Kiva Parsons, who then returns the puck to Roslinski, who advances up the ice now into the offensive zone. He's forced wide left, but gets a shot off. Kira Waddington with a save, and then Jujinska just bundling over one of her opponents, and then forward as the Rattlesnakes look to counter. Nice end-to-end hockey here, but Capitals defending well there with a poke check coming in from Aurora Dobbs. She's driving forward. Into a corner. McMahon sends it towards goal, but then it's picked off by the Rattlesnakes. Carla Jones drifts wide left, gets in behind the wall with Dobbs, who goes for the attempted poke check, comes off the back of a blade there off the Capitals, but Voslinski will hold on and look to carry out a couple of dangles there as he takes it past the Rattlesnakes and fends off a third challenge into the offensive zone now, gets a shot off, it's blocked. But it is end-to-end action here at I Sheffield. 2 minutes to go in the period. Tied at one. Freeland. Ooh, I thought she was going to keep it in there, but it's... it was actually coming out the zone, wasn't it? As Carla Jones was going the other way. Shot across the face of goal. Connie Fiedler over on that far side. Christina Powell advancing up the ice. Picked off though by the Capitals as they'll look to split the D, but Rattlesnakes getting back and clearing it away from goal and then getting the chance to bank it off the boards and out. Tegan Walsh couldn't hold on. Izzy Zizinska looks to advance, but Kiva Parsons steals in ahead of her. Boards in the corner.
1 minute remaining in the second period. 1 minute remaining in the second period.
Action continuing in that over on that far side. Keeper Parsons banks it off the boards, collected in the neutral zone by the Rattlesnakes. Over to Christina Powell, who's open. Forward. Towards Freeland, who will advance, gets it past Tegan Walsh, but not past Kiva Parsons, who strips her of the puck. Pomeranz trying to get involved there, but can't control. And then Tegan Walsh will advance. Shot comes in, nice glove save there by Kira Waddington with 15 seconds left in the period. And we're going to face off in the offensive zone then. Face off in the corner. That will do it then for the period. Still remains tied then, and we'll take another short break. We'll be back with you in 5 minutes' time, so please don't go anywhere. Apologies, there's going to be an ice cut, so it will be around 15 minutes, but see you all shortly. Welcome back then to I Sheffield, as we've had an extended break between the ice cut as there was a lot of standing water, some jokes about had we played the final period at Ponds Forge, which is a huge International Swimming Pool in Sheffield. But they have got rid of the standing water, and we can resume this final then between the Chelmsford Rattlesnakes and the London Capitals, and it is finally poised as we head into this final 15-minute period. Both these sides know each other well. They're in the same Southern Conference, so have met four times this year. And on the first three of those occasions, it was Chelmsford who won as they went on their way to winning the championship. But that's going to be a good save by Kuzaris, the goalie for the Capitals. 30 seconds gone, and an offensive zone face-off then for the Chelmsford Rattlesnakes. Back to a point. Christina Powell. Kick save by Kuzaris. Nice hands there in the corner from Izzy Zizinska. By Tegan Walsh. Sorry, from Wyslinski even. Christina Powell sticks with her. Aurora Dobbs is open. She will receive. Oh, just comes off her forehand and then has to check back. Freeland putting her under pressure. And the Rattlesnakes looking to counter now. Fiedler looking to enter his zone. She was cut off there. Good defending by the Caps, and that ensures that we'll get a icing call on the Rattlesnakes. And a minute 21 played here in the third and final period. Still tied at one then. And coming up for you next will be the Division 2 final between the Southern champions Cardiff Comets and the Northern champions Caledonia Steel Queens. It'll be a Scotland versus Wales final, just like we had last year. Different Scottish team this time, but Cardiff making their second final in a row as the Rattlesnakes looking to enter the zone. Aurora Dobbs with a nice poke check. Controlled by Neve Walsh. Forced out wide by Zizinska, who's back there helping out her D. Rattlesnakes looking to get away. Fiedler's lost her glove there. There's Pomeranz. It wasn't an intentional slash, but you've seen them given. Farah Jones digging the puck out from the board. She'll drop back behind the goal and just allow her team to get set. Going to check back there because they weren't quite ready. Now she'll go again with Neve Walsh putting her under pressure. Oh, she's has been forced back, but has to go again. This time she will carry out and then collected on the blue line by the Capitals, who sends the puck back the other way. 2 minutes 38 played here at the start of his third period. Out wide, picked off the boards by Wharf. Well, crept up the blue line there by Quilter for the Rattlesnakes. Replay here. There's the poke check, enough to put Neve Walsh off, and then just over the outstretched glove. And then cleared from the zone as we're back underway. Over on that far side. Shot on there. It's a big save by Kuzaris. I think the net might be off slightly, and she's just putting it back on now. Yeah, did look like a right footed kick the net off in action, making that save. Southwood. Controlled and carried in. Shot on net, big save by Kuzaris. She'll hold on. And the Rattlesnakes really making a good start to this period. And Kuzaris has been tested on a number of occasions as the shot coming in from the high slot. But strong high glove save. 3:30 played then. Jamie Briggs ready to drop the puck. Zora Gottlebet is the senior referee for this one, and she was the player of the game in the Elite Final 2 years ago, as she helped the Guildford Lightning win the playoffs on that occasion. Guildford very nearly getting to the final again yesterday. They gave the Vixens a scare, didn't they? What a game that was. But Vixens showing that experience at the end of a game to get it done. Big game player Katie Henry coming up with the winner in overtime, as we've got a call here for tripping on Chandler. So a power play for the Rattlesnakes as their momentum continues to build. 3:59 played here then in this third period, and Connie Fiedler will take the draw. Izzy Jasinska out on the right hand side, cleared by the Capitals. Control between the hash marks by the Capitals. They're going to hold on, just keeping that puck possession to run down some of the penalty clock. Roslinski looking to carry out Jasinska, giving her a bit of a nudge on the way through, but it was Christina Powell who blocked that pass into the zone. Christina has had a really strong tournament. It's going to be difficult in terms of, because we'll get the All-Star announcements later on in, well, at the end of this game. For me, I think she's got to be in contention for defensive All-Star. Same with Aurora Dobbs and Kiva Parsons for the Capitals. That's going to be a difficult one, actually, to decide between the three of them. Through the crease and over onto his near side. Cleared and out just out of reach of Carla Jones. That'll be gathered in by Kira Waddington. Fiedler. Centre on the boards. Collected off his near side by Voslinski. Oh, she's gone down there. There was some slight contact, but she went down well after that. I don't know if it was just because the ice is still quite slick. She looked like she lost an edge. She's not certainly not claiming anything, and I don't think it was a challenge from the chance of play that brought her down. But there was slight contact just prior to that. But the Capitals able to kill that penalty off then. 6:02 gone at the start of this third period. It's carried in on that far side by the Capitals. Still nothing between the two sides. Are we going to get another OT? We had two games yesterday that went the distance. Worth tips it in. Shot's blocked by Adamson. Shot comes in, Kira with a big save. Controlled in the corner. Carla Jones sends it across. Rattlesnakes trying to control in the offensive zone. Unable to convert on that power play. Didn't create a great deal of scoring opportunities on it, but that was more down to the strong defence from the Capitals as Niamh Walsh looking to get away. That's good positional play there by Smith, who just came across using her body to block off that entry into the zone. But Capitals looking to control, but they won't do so there. 7:20 played in this third period. Kiva Parsons controls at centre red. She enters the zone, looks to advance towards that, fires. Combination of a stick and the pads there from Kira, sending the puck wide. Controlled by the Rattlesnakes beyond the back of the net. Fiedler. Move on to that far side. Deegan Walsh carries in under pressure from Christina Paolo, who does a good job of stripping her opponent of the puck again. Such a smart defender. And you can see why she's getting international recognition now. Izzy Zizinska carries in, another great talent. Lovely to get back onto her forehand there and then advancing towards goal, but cutting through three defenders, couldn't quite get the shot off. But such a tight game here still. 8:28 gone. We're past the midpoint of a final period as Aurora Dobbs advances up the ice. It's cleared, comes back to the Capitals and Abbey Gray. Chandler on that far side. Look in the corner. In by Quilter, who's pinching it from the blue line. Aurora Dobbs keeping it honest in that corner there, wouldn't let her advance towards goal. But then it comes to Cara Jones, the shot's blocked by Chandler, and then away with second shot steered away by, I think it was Abbey Gray who got the block in there. Matilda Howell just closing off on this near side. Out defensively. Good work over on the far side by the Capitals there, and Daisy Ailey back come the Rattlesnakes at the other end of the ice. Inside the final 5 minutes then, 10:15 played. Clear. Christina Powell will drop back and collect on her blue line. She has time. Action behind the back of the net now. Rattlesnakes slowly making their way forward. Fiedler can't control. Kiva Parsons looks to... Sorry, no, it wasn't. It was Dalio. Her defensive partner. Three and a half minutes to go then in regulation time as Kira Waddington will make the save. We're going to face off in the zone then. Slight delay then as they make a line change. Back underway. Nice. Capitals looking to carry in. Forces Kira into a save. Got the replay coming up now. Shot, yeah, using Jasinska's a screen there, but she got the shot on net, and Kira full-length dive to make that stop. Offensive zone face-off then for the Capitals. Coming off the foot of the official. McMahon not in a position to capitalise on it, though. And then the Rattlesnakes using the boards to clear his zone, and they'll look to enter a zone at the other end at full speed, carried in on that far side by Cara Jones, who's had a really strong third period. Christina Powell comes across. Switches a play to the opposite corner. The hands there from Vasilinski hit Kira high up in the shoulder. It was a good save there. She just went up on her tiptoes there to make sure she got the height to block off as we're approaching the final 3 minutes, sorry, 2 minutes even, of the game. It's time for a winner here, almost stab time. It's blasted clear by the Capitals. That should go for icing, and indeed it will. Offensive zone face-off then for the Rattlesnakes as we see the play again on the replay. Any viewers from Teesside now, I'm sure will be happy. They love a bit of pig bag. Jamie Briggs, the official, she's from Teesside. It's controlled behind the back of the net then by Vasilinski. She'll wind up and look to get forward. Back to Aurora Dobbs. Batted out of the air by Vasilinski. Keeping the puck at full length there, brought down, no call. It would be a brave decision to make a call this late in the game. Two players sparring with one another there with their sticks. I don't think they're too happy, but it's going to be some tight and close marking right now. Puck comes in, it's going to be behind the back of the net, and it's the Rattlesnakes who control as we're inside the final minute then. Looks like we're heading towards OT. Buck will cycle back round. Carla Jones, oh, it was almost won there by Jasinska. Put it back into the low slot, but it just wouldn't fall for her. Now the Capitals have a chance to counter with 25 seconds to go in regulation. Christina Powell, she will control forward to the blue line and then up towards the left wing, and the players brought down on the far side. I didn't quite see what happens, but they've carried on, and Jasinska had the chance to win it there, but Kiva Parsons with some great defending, and the Capitals player's gone down. She's not moved with 10 seconds to go. It was a heavy collision. She's getting up, though. Well, that's good to see. So, yeah, the medics are ready to jump on. A replay of what happened here, but it was as you can see in the final seconds, it's gonna, everything's on the line, so some desperate plays will be seen. Thankfully she's okay, and we've got a face off in the capital zone then. Clear, that should do it then, and we are going to overtime.
Well, we're all square in regulation, so you know what that means. Overtime.
So we'll take a very short break then, as we have a minute timeout essentially for both sides to regroup, and we'll just leave the background noise on for you for the next few seconds. So the timeout's complete. We are getting ready for 3-on-3 overtime. It's the third time of these finals weekends where that has happened. See which teams, which players they start, I should say. Voslinski's certainly out there for the Capitals. And we are underway then. Chelmsford will control. That will be Zhizhinska on the left wing. Voslinski comes across. He was, well, it's a safe bet both of those two would start for their respective sides. And they've scored. It's over. And Chelmsford only needed 25 seconds to get the job done. It was not a stop. It was not a chance to win it in regulation. There's nothing between the sides. And mere seconds after the game has started, it's the Rattlesnakes who get the job done. And well, two celebrations at either end of the ice. They've all gone together in a massive huddle. But congratulations to the Chelmsford Rattlesnakes then. Regular season champions of the South. So perhaps always going to be the favourites for this one. But I'll tell you what, the Capitals have given everything. Here's a replay of the goal now. Puck in the corner. Cleared by Aurora Dobbs, but then it just comes back. Backhand. Cara Jones with a winner. Stabbing it home on the backhand. What a way to win it. But, well, all we needed was 25 seconds to settle it then in OT. And what a way to do so. Congratulations again to the Rattlesnakes. And we will have the post-game presentations coming up, for which there will be a few of them. But yeah, hearts go out to the London Capitals, because they gave it everything. Didn't deserve to lose in a game like that. No, neither team did, but they've given everything. And just in the end, it's become something of a lottery, much like a shootout really, and the way that games can unfold, what it is for on three like that. It's the reservations for London, and congratulations. But London can be proud of their performance, the way it's gone this weekend. And we will get the post-game handshakes in, as we will discuss player of the game and contenders. Well, for the Capitals, I think Rebecca Voslinski would be in consideration, because she was driving the team forward at every opportunity. But you would have to say as well, goalie Sofia Kuzaris, who's had a really strong weekend. She made a lot of saves in that game, particularly in that final period. I thought it was a two goalies there, and Brayton, it's Voslinski and Kira Waddington there, who know each other well. All these players do. Some of them play on the same senior teams together. For Chelmsford, Christina Powell, I thought, was very strong on defence. Obviously, Izzy Jajinska is always good going forward. Match winner coming from Cara Jones, and she was strong throughout as well. So be interesting to see what happens there, as the players are still completing the handshakes with the officials. There could be some time yet, but well, the last few years we've seen really good finals for different reasons. This was no less dramatic. Nothing between them throughout regulation, throughout the 45 minutes. But then, into that 3-on-3 sudden death overtime, and that opportunity coming the way of the Rattlesnakes. The girls still celebrating and dancing, jumping up and down. Christina Powell there, celebrating with Sophia Smith, and Sophie Smith, I should say. My apologies.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, once again,
we shall see how the announcements go then. We will have the Player of the Game awards first. But then we will get the All-Star awards as well. So, we are just waiting for the announcements now. But a great way to start the day then.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, if our blood pressure has come down, it's time first to do the Player of the Game presentations.
And here we go,
as
guys.
Usual, we have our General Manager of the WNIHR.
That's Faye Andrews, who's going to take over the announcements
and
now.
First up, for the London Capitals, it's going to number 24, Kiva Parsons.
Kiva Parsons, yeah, she's always good in every game I've seen her. Whether it's at under 16 level or in the Elite League with the Guildford Lightning. She had a strong game yesterday, didn't she, against the Vixens. But well done to Kiva. Jones, no surprise there with the game winner, but as I say, aside from that, I think throughout she was very strong and looked like she was trying to get the game won throughout regulation. So now it will be Faye Andrews who takes over the announcements for the All-Star presentation, so we will see how these go. Outstanding talent, and we've seen her have a great season with the Guildford Lightning as well, but been great not just in this game but across the whole weekend for the Rattlesnakes.
Playoff All-Star forward 2024.
This is for a defender now.
Someone's paying
attention.
Goes to Aurora Dobbs.
Defender goes to Aurora Dobbs then. It was probably going to go to either Kiva Aurora on the Capitals or Christina Powell for Chelmsford. It's gone to Aurora. It's a very, very close that one, I would have thought.
Best netminder, Kira Waddington.
Kira Waddington. And again, there was an argument for Sophia Kizaris as well. Nothing between the two of them. Well done to all three then, the first three All-Stars of the weekend. And that, well, brings us up to a trophy presentation for the playoff winners.
We have a trophy to present, then we will present the hats. But can we ask the captain of the Chelmsford Rattlesnakes to come forward? Come on, Cara. Ladies and gentlemen, your 2023-24 WNIHL Under-16s Playoff Champions, the Chelmsford
Rattlesnakes. Carver Jones then, it's your moment and the moment of your teammates, the Chelmsford Rattlesnakes, who are Under-16 champions. They suffered that disappointing loss in the semi-final last year, but they've come back even stronger this year and are deserved playoff champions. There is a lot of talent on that team, and you will be seeing all those names flooding the WNIHL rosters over the next few years, so do keep a lookout for them. But a great team as Carver Jones takes it over to the bench and the coaches. What a nice moment that is. Jenny Bolton as well, a coach who's a player for the Chelmsford Cobras in Division 1. Nice moment for her as well, but well done to Chelmsford. They've got a huge backing behind their bench, decked out in the black and amber over there. But well done once again to the Chelmsford Rattlesnakes and to the London Capitals, who put in a fantastic performance across the weekend. Thank you to both teams. We are going to take a short break. I think there might be another ice cup before the next final, which is a Division 2 one between the Caledonia Steel Queens and the Cardiff Comets. So please do check back in a few moments' time. We're going to take a short break. See you all shortly.